I got a good bad idea. Let's get out of here. I can't end up north or south, but if it goes good, problem solved. I got a good bad idea right now, right here. What could go wrong with a little flirting? As long as I can say you kissed me first, yeah.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Great Day Houston. He is performing in the Thanksgiving Day Parade in a few days, but we've got a preview today. Will Carter, hello there.
Hey.
All right, so this parade gets different every year, and it grows every year, but why not feature the largest of its kind in the world, the rodeo? So you'll be up on that float performing.
Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo Float, that is correct.
Yeah, all right. We should probably start out with another song, and that song is Reunited and It Feels
Funny
So
story
Good.
Behind that.
Yeah, tell us the story. Tell the folks the story.
So when I was 13 years old, I was actually asked to be on the Deborah Duncan Show, and I was letting her know this morning how I had her picture in my room after I did that, and I had the biggest crush on her.
Oh, look at that. You're 13. Oh, my gosh. So you're 16 years old now,
that's
right?
Correct.
Yeah, yeah.
16 and a half.
Oh, my gosh. He's like a grown man now. That's very cool. But you started singing way before 13.
That's correct.
Three years old. Yeah.
Absolutely. My dad was a big guy, 6'4", 250 pounds, and thought I was going to be a football player. And he married my mom, and she's very beautiful, but she's 5'3 and weighs like 90 pounds.
Right.
So I did not quite grow into the football player physique, but he put me in dance, tap, jazz, and ballet for agility when
well,
I was 3 years
like
old.
Well, it's kind of like Patrick Swayze did the same thing,
right?
Right? He did ballet. His mom, Patsy, was a dancer and stuff, and so, yeah.
And then, but when I didn't grow into it, I started doing music instead, but
yeah.
That sort of started me in that whole field.
Yeah, and then country music, and you have like, you said you really love kind of that 90s type of music, and a lot of the people that you were mentioning were your influences, or people that I interviewed when they first came into the, because I'm older than you, first came into that 90s type of country.
Yeah, that's what I grew up on. You know, my first CD that I ever learned back in the karaoke days when we would sing the karaoke tracks was a 15 song John Michael Montgomery CD. So
I have the CD in my car right now.
Check it out.
Right? Yeah.
I learned every one of those, and so, you know, I grew up listening to him, Mark Chestnut, those guys that were big back in the early 90s, and I take a lot of my influence from that era. That was the music that I grew up on and I really love.
Yeah, you went to A&M.
Yes, ma'am.
And majored in construction.
Construction science, got a minor in business.
Yeah.
Yes.
When did you decide that really this is what really set your heart on fire is the country music?
Man, I want to say when I was 13, honestly.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it was.
The
thank
impact
you for that.
I have on people, right?
I appreciate that. That's when I really focused on it. I started playing fairs and festivals and kind of getting out. I was hired as a lead singer for a big dancehall band called The Emotions here in Texas right after high school, and played all through college, and then wanted to start writing original music. So right after college is when I went down that path, started writing my own music and getting on the radio and that kind of stuff.
And you see your dad at first, who thought you were going to be that big football player, really jumped in behind you.
He really did.
Well.
He was my biggest supporter. I lost my father to cancer when I was 13. Prior to that, though, he pushed me. Oh, he would drive. We didn't have a lot of money, but he would drive me anywhere I could get in to play or perform. The music thing was something he couldn't do. Being 6'4", he could do anything, right?
Yeah.
He was Superman, but that was something he couldn't do, and he really, really supported me. And I remember I put out a CD to raise money when he got to where he couldn't work anymore, and the last 2 months of his life, he would listen to that CD on repeat, just 24/7.
You've got your crosses on here, both your crosses, and let me tell you, he still supports you. That is your guardian angel.
I know this.
Yeah, your first release was With You, and your next album, Good Bad Idea, that you released that in 2018, or 2019?
2019, yeah. Yes, ma'am.
All right, what are you going to sing for us now?
That Kiss.
All right, now performing That Kiss off his latest EP, Will Carter.
We roll straight into it.
I remember that Saturday night, full moon in the sky, you spinning in your sundress. I remember that wind in your hair, you dance everywhere, me lost in your silhouette. I don't remember what I did to make you want to let me lean on in, but I remember that kiss. It all changed in a minute. It never was the same again. Before I knew it, I was in it. So much deeper than I'd ever been. There was a one-hit addiction. The last kiss I'd ever need. Don't quite remember who started it. It don't matter, cause you're here with me. And I remember that Saturday night, full moon in the sky, you spinning in your sundress. I remember that when sky. You spin it in your sundress. I remember.